Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Tuesday of the second week of Easter. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Let us rejoice and be glad and give glory to God, for the Lord our God, the Almighty, reigns. Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Enable us, we pray, Almighty God, to proclaim the power of the risen Lord, that we who have received the pledge of His gift may come to possess all He gives when it is fully revealed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was of one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them, bring the proceeds of the sale, and put them at the feet of the apostles, and they were distributed to each according to need. Thus Joseph, also named by the apostles Barnabas, which is translated son of encouragement, a Levite, a Cypriot by birth, sold a piece of property that he owned, then brought the money and put it at the feet of the apostles. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is King, He is robed in majesty.
The Lord is King, He is robed in majesty.
The Lord is King, in splendor robed. Robed is the Lord and girt about with strength.
The Lord is King, He is robed in majesty.
And He has made the world firm, not to be moved. Your throne stands firm from of old, from everlasting you are, O Lord.
The Lord is King, He is robed in majesty.
Your decrees are worthy of trust indeed. Holiness befits your house, O Lord, for length of days.
The Lord is King, He is robed in majesty.
Alleluia, alleluia. The Son of Man must be lifted up so that everyone who believes in Him may have eternal life. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to Nicodemus, "You must be born from above. The wind blows where it wills, and you can hear the sound it makes. But you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit." Nicodemus answered and said to him, "How can this happen?" Jesus answered and said to him, "You are the teacher of Israel, and you do not understand this. Amen, amen, I say to you, we speak of what we know, and we testify to what we have seen. But you people do not accept our testimony. If I tell you about earthly things, and you do not believe, how will you believe if I tell you about heavenly things? No one has gone up to heaven except the one who has come down from heaven, the Son of Man. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the desert, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, so that everyone who believes in Him may have eternal life." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today we begin to read, no, from chapter 3 of the Gospel of John, and this is that conversation with Nicodemus. No, and just to sort of introduce, no, the next 2 weeks, we begin with the conversation with Nicodemus, and some major themes, no, will come up during the next 2 weeks. Of course, here now you talk about being born in the Spirit, no, and many other themes about the truth, about the light. Then after that, you have that entire, it's going to be the multiplication of the loaves and fish, which will occasion now another major theme, no, the bread of life. So that is sort of, so to speak, the lay of the land the next 2 weeks, no, with regard to our reflections, no. So first about Nicodemus, no. Maybe just a context, no, that Nicodemus went to the Lord in the evening, in the dark of night, no. And that is very symbolic, but at the same time, some commentators would say, no, that he went in the night so that he will not be seen. Remember, he belonged to the ruling, the leaders of the people, the religious leaders of his time, no. So that's why he went in the night, in the darkness of night, so that he will not be seen. But it's also symbolic, no, of his knowledge of as the Lord said, no, of earthly and heavenly truths, no. And then the points that I invite you to reflect on is when the Lord tells Nicodemus, you must be born again, no. And then the second is that to see now how the Lord critiques, no, I won't use the word criticizes, but critiques Nicodemus's lack of understanding, considering that he was a teacher, no. He belonged to the class of religious leaders, no. And then of course the third point is the lifting up at the very end of the gospel, no. This is where the Lord talks about this being lifted up, no. First about Nicodemus being born again, no. Of course this is where we get that very popular term that we must be born again, no. But remember, this is the gift of the Lord, no, to all of us Christians, no, that we are all born again, because the Lord says you must be born again in the Spirit, no. And I think, again, we must emphasize what I've always mentioned, diba, during this Easter season, since last week, that we now live in the time of the Spirit, no? That the church lives in the time of the Spirit and the Spirit of the risen Lord. That's why for us to begin our reflections, no, after the Easter octave, after reading all the resurrection appearances, it's a nice start. Of course, yesterday we had the incarnation, which is also a beautiful way to begin, no, the Easter season after the octave. But today we also begin with a very beautiful theme, no? To be born in the Spirit. And again, I invite you, no, to undergo that spiritual rebirth, no? And to remember that we are asked to be born again, or the grace to be born again in the Spirit is available to us. And to be born again in the Spirit of the risen Lord, no? As I always say, the resurrection is the ultimate game changer in our lives, because it gives that horizon in our lives, no, that really goes beyond, no, the here and now, no. So that first point to reflect on, the meaning of being born again, that is available to all of us Christians, no. Even the Catholics, no, we are born again. We are born again in the Spirit of the risen Lord, no. It is not in a sense limited to any Christian denomination or sect, no, but it is to all the followers of Christ. We are born again, no. And then the second is Nicodemus is grappling with this. In fact, when the Lord says that you must be born in the Spirit, he questions that, no? And it showed his lack of understanding, no? And I think this is a very good thing then to sort of reflect on, no? That for us to accept our lack of understanding, the need for us to deepen our understanding, the need for us to deepen our appreciation of Scripture, our appreciation of the mysteries of our faith, our appreciation of the sacraments, of the traditions and devotions of our faith, to deepen everything, no? Because the Lord says, no, you lack the understanding, no? That's why the symbol of Nicodemus going to the Lord in the darkness of night is not simply out of fear of being seen, but it also, in a sense, is a very dramatic, in a sense, portrayal, no, or description of his level of understanding, no? And then, as he begins, no, as he goes through this conversation with the Lord, no, he begins to at least consider the other truths. And of course, later on, I can't remember what day in the coming days we will talk about the light, no, and how people decide to stay in the darkness, no. But the invitation is Christ is the light, no, and the light of truth, no. But later on, you will see Nicodemus. We saw him during Holy Week in the trial, no, in the Passion. Remember when the Sanhedrin was accusing Christ, no, Nicodemus was the one who spoke that we must hear his side. Remember, they were beginning to condemn him without the Lord being present, no. They're beginning to hatch that evil plan, no, to put him to death. And Nicodemus was the one who spoke, no, that we must allow him to speak, no. That is part of the due process. And then he was silenced, no. But you begin to see how Nicodemus was able to grow from the darkness of the ignorance of the faith or the truth, no? And slowly, no, believing now in Christ, no? Coming to the light, no? And I think that is also part of our journey. And for us to ask for that grace, I guess the light of Christ, no? To help us understand more our faith. What are we believing in? What are we dedicating our lives to? What are we devoting our lives to? What are our devotions all about? And then the third and final point is, for me, this begin with the end in mind. Because remember, when the Lord says, when the Son of Man is lifted up, from the beginning, He refers now to His cross and resurrection. And I think it's a very powerful message at the start of the conversation with Nicodemus, that when I am lifted up on the cross and when I am lifted up in the glory of the resurrection, then everything will be drawn to me. I will be the way to salvation. No? And for me, that is the end in mind. That is the end of our journey of faith. No? So, ngayong araw, no, tingnan natin itong ebanghelyo ito kasi napakahalagang ebanghelyo. No? Itong darating na dalawang linggo, nauukol to sa ano yung unang bahagi, yung isa kanilang usapan ni Nicodemus, no? At pagkatapos noon, magkakaroon naman ng multiplication of the loaves and fish, no? Yung miracle, no? At tapos noon, pag-uusapan naman, papasok naman yung the discourse on the bread of life, na isa ring napakahalagang masasabi nating katotohanan, no, ng ating pananampalataya. Dito sa kwento ni Nicodemus, no, siguro maganda rin na makita natin na bilang introduction, nagpunta siya sa Panginoon nung gabi. Sabi nga ng mga scholar, nagpunta siya nung kinagabihan kasi ayaw niyang makita siya ng kapwa niya kasi religious authority siya. He was part of the Sanhedrin and the religious authorities. So ayaw niyang makita siya dahil nga parang baka yun nga ma-persecute din siya o mapunlaan siya. Pero meron din tong simbolismo, no? Na nasa pa kadiliman pa yung kanyang pag-unawa sa pananampalataya at pagninilayan natin, no? So ang unang punto ng pagninilay ay si Nicodemus sinabihan, kailangan mong maging born again. Kailangan ka ipanganak ulit, no? Yun yung unang punto. Tapos yung pangalawa ay yung puna ng Panginoon. Hindi, sabi ko nga, hindi kritisismo, kundi puna. Yung puna ng Panginoon na hindi nyo nauunawaan yung mga bagay, no? Yung mga katotohanan, no? Ukol sa buhay na walang hanggan, ukol sa mga katotohanan ng langit, ano? Sabi ng Panginoon. Tapos yung panghuli ay yung katapos ng ebanghelyo. Sabi ng Panginoon na pag ako ay inangat, ano, ito ngayon yung huling punto ng ating pagninilay. Una yung pagiging born again, no? Na mahalagang makita natin na sabi ng Panginoon, kailangan yung muling ipanganak or isula, isilang o iluwal sa Espiritu. You must be born again in the Spirit. Ito ay nangangahulugan, di ba? Kasi nga, lagi nating sinasabi na ang panahon ng simbahan ngayon ay panahon ng Espiritu. At Espiritu ng Panginoon na muling nabuhay. Kaya mahalaga na lahat tayo ay muling iluwal o isilang sa Espiritu. At ito ay Espiritu ng Panginoon na muling nabuhay. Ito ang biyaya na binibigay sa lahat ng Kristiyano. No? Kaya hindi Katoliko o Katoliko, lahat ng Kristiyano ay born again. Lahat tayo ay sinilang sa Espiritu ng Panginoon na muling nabuhay. Na mahalaga yun na maunawaan natin na bahagi yan ng ating pananampalataya. At ang pagsasabuhay natin bilang isang simbahan, ay ang simbahan ay nabubuhay sa panahon ng Espiritu. Espiritu ng Panginoon na muling nabuhay. At yung pangalawang punto ng pagninila ay yung kakulangan ng pag-unawa. Ano? Sabi ng Panginoon kay Nicodemus, ganun din tayo. No? Hilingin natin ang liwanag ng pag-unawa, liwanag ng Panginoon na muling nabuhay. Upang higit nating maunawaan ang kalaliman, no, at ang masasabi natin ang biyaya, mga katotohanan ng ating pananampalataya. At higit sa lahat, no, ang katotohanan at biyaya ng krus at muling pagkabuhay. Na yun ang isang mahalaga rin natin na hingin ngayon itong ating paglalakbay ngayong panahon ng Easter, no. Kasi makikita natin kay Nicodemus, 'di ba, nagsimula ito chapter 3, no. Pagdating naman sa chapter 19, noong pasyon ng Panginoon, di ba, nung pinagbabalakan na ang Panginoon ng mga religious authorities na ayan, kailangan natin itong kundina, kailangan itong papako sa krus. Si Nicodemus nagsalita. Sabi niya, di ba, kailangan marinig natin ang kanyang panig. At yun, pinintasan siya at binuli. No? Pero makita nyo, unti-unti siyang napunta sa liwanag. No? mula sa kadiliman itong unang pag-uusap nila, unti-unti siyang pumunta sa liwanag ng Panginoon. At ganyan din ang ating paglalakbay, no? Na mula sa kadiliman ng kakulangan ng pag-unawa, sana ay mapunta tayo sa liwanag, ano, ng Espiritu ng Panginoon. At yung panghuling punto ng pagninilay, yung sinabi ng Panginoon sa katapusan ng Ebanghelyo, na kagaya ng pag-angat ni Moises doon sa mga ahas, no, sa disyerto, ako, ang anak ng Diyos, ay iaangat din. At ito nga, tandaan natin, ito ay ang pag-angat sa krus at pag-angat sa muling pagkabuhay ng Panginoon. At sabi niya, lahat ay maniniwala sa pamamagitan ko upang magkaroon ng buhay na walang hanggan. Yan kasi ang sukdulan at masasabi natin, pinakamahalagang biyaya na atin dapat tunguin. Today, let us pray, no, that in the coming days, we may have a deeper appreciation of our faith, a deeper appreciation of our devotions, our practices, no? And let us ask the Lord to grant us the grace of His light that we may fully and more deeply understand the cross and resurrection, that we may live born again in the Spirit of the risen Lord. With confidence, we bring our cares and concerns before God the Father, who loved the world so much that He gave His only Son, so that everyone who believes in Him may not be lost, but may have eternal life. To each prayer, our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
That those invested with authority may be inspired by the Spirit to exercise their leadership in the spirit of love and service, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may renew ourselves constantly in the Spirit and grow in love to the perfect maturity of Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For us celebrating this Eucharist, that we may help one another with the love which reflects the Trinity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. And today we also pray for our country as we celebrate Araw ng Kagitingan, used to be Bataan Day. Let's pray that people will raise up more heroes, more valiant Filipinos to really work for the good of our people. And let's pray especially for the youth, no, that they may have role models and that they may also become heroes in their own way. Let's also continue to pray for the good health of the Holy Father, Pope Francis. We pray for his intentions, especially for his prayers for peace. And let's also pray for the coming Synod on Synodality. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers, with angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now let us offer our prayer for Easter.
Risen Lord, may the joy of this season inspire us to renew our friendship with you as your companions in mission. Open our mind, heart, and spirit to the truth and grace of sacred scripture, and may the story of the journey of your disciples and the early church renew our own journey of mission in our world today. Enliven our faith that we may do all things in joyful, loving obedience and witness to the saving power of your cross and resurrection. May we be a sign of hope in our world today and bring the victory of your cross and resurrection over the evil of violence, injustice and war, over sin and death. Risen Lord, make our hearts burn within us that we may set our world on fire within the love and mercy of your heart. Amen.
And let us pray. Hear, O Lord, our prayers that this most holy exchange by which you have redeemed us may bring your help in this present life and ensure for us eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God, bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Marami pong salamat and again, enjoy the holiday. Thank you very much and thank you for joining us.
I can't feed 5,000, but I can feed one. I can't walk in water, but I can walk in the shoes of another. I can't turn water into wine, but I can turn a frown into a smile. Sharing what I have in my hands is the miracle that needs to be seen today. Every blessing I receive is a miracle that I can share. This is what I can share. This is my Alay Kapwa.
Alay Kapwa, a flagship program of Caritas Philippines by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.